Good morning, children, and welcome to our virtual Sunday school. Hope you all are doing well. Children, we have finished with the Northern Kingdom of Israel, and now we turn our attention to the Southern Jewish Kingdom of Judah. In the previous class, we saw that few faithful people escaped to Judah, that is the Southern Kingdom. The two possible enemies of Judah besides Israel could be Assyria to the north and Egypt to the south. Now let us see an interesting discovery about Hezekiah's tunnel, the secret tunnel. This interesting discovery existed in Jerusalem about 2700 years ago. It is an underground tunnel built by King Hezekiah of Judah to pipe water from the spring of Gihon. The discovery of the tunnel happened this way. One hot day in the year 1880, a student exploring Jerusalem's old city came upon it accidentally. Entering the tunnel, she slipped and fell. Getting up, she noticed strange writings on the wall. It turned out to be an inscription in ancient Hebrew script telling how King Hezekiah hurriedly built the tunnel to ensure enough water supply for the city. Water still flows through the tunnel. Some tourists still explore it. It is nearly 1,800 feet long. Hezekiah built this secret tunnel because he knew that when Jerusalem would be surrounded by enemies, the success in resisting the enemies often depended on having enough water for the citizens. Since the supply of water for Jerusalem came from the Gihon spring, which was outside the city walls, he built this underground tunnel so that the water could safely come for the citizens to the pool of Siloam within the walls. A real engineering marvel for the people of those times. This is the spring where Jesus healed the blind man. To capture a fortified place, the methods of war at that time was different from war in our present days. The besiegers tried their best to break the walls with battering rams. That is, they used to strike violently a door down. How would the Jews feel to be inside such a besieged city, especially if you know that the enemy is cruel? At this situation, the Jews would have had a confused feeling whether to trust God, the king, or the prophet. Very often, this was the situation for the Jews. In such situations, the king faced with an option of listening to or rejecting to the message of God's prophets. So in this lesson, you will learn about a Hebrew prophet, Isaiah, who guided King Hezekiah, and how God used the circumstances in the people's lives to build up their confidence in him as their only Lord and Savior. Let us see the situation in Judah. People in Judah depended upon the power of their king. They were either able to save themselves against their enemies or suffer defeat. Faced with such a situation, Judah often relied on its own smartness. For example, the Hezekiah's channel, or were united with their neighboring kings, which in turn had to respect foreign gods that the king worshipped. Judah, therefore, constantly faced the temptation to bow down before other gods, forgetting its own covenant with Yahweh. Therefore, people followed all the immoral practices and injustice towards one another. Prophet Isaiah was inspired by God to see through what was happening at that time and guided the kings and the people. Isaiah was born about 770 BC and came from a noble family. He was a friend and advisor of the kings of Judah. We will now watch a video about an important incident in the life of Prophet Isaiah.
Long, long time ago, in the kingdom of Judah, there lived a man named Isaiah. One day, as usual, he was going to the temple to pray.
How beautiful is your temple, Lord? I feel so good every time I come here.
Isaiah was praying as usual that day. He knelt down and closed his eyes to pray. But then, suddenly, he had a vision. In that vision, he was given a deep awareness of the holiness of God. The vision also showed him his sins.
No, I'm a sinner. I live among sinners. How am I going to live with this burden? God, please help me.
Then suddenly, one of the seraphs flew to Isaiah with a burning coal taken from the altar.
Open your mouth. Now that this has touched your lips, all your sins will be washed away.
Whom shall I send to proclaim my word? Here I am. Send me. Go and preach to the people. Even if they hear my words again and again, they still won't understand. Even when they see again and again, they still won't notice. They have hardened their heart. But still, speak to them.
Isaiah was purified by God and called to proclaim his word. The newly gained awareness made him aware of the sins of the society in which he lived. He saw the poor and the weak were oppressed and exploited. He realized that the sacrifices and rituals were simply a show of human glory.
As we saw in the video, Prophet Isaiah's call to speak for God came to him when he had an extraordinary vision while he was in the temple of Jerusalem. He had a vision in which he saw the throne of God suspended in the heaven, and God's robe filled the entire temple. around God's throne, seraphim, the angels, chanted happily and beautifully by saying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The temple was filled with smoke. Prophet Isaiah, who had glimpsed the glory of heaven for only an instant, felt himself overcome by the presence of God. This presence suddenly revealed to Isaiah his own unworthiness. He cried out, "Woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips." Then one of the seraphim took a burning coal from the heavenly altar. He flew toward the prophet and touched and purified his lips with the burning coal. The entire vision had a lasting effect on Isaiah. The purification of his lips meant that God was purifying the people and he wanted them to have confidence in him alone. Let's see how God saves Jerusalem. Not all the kings that Isaiah spoke listened to his advice. King Hezekiah, for a long period of time, followed what Prophet Isaiah told him and stayed clear among the obstacles. But his confidence in God was put to the test by the Assyrians, who threatened to capture Jerusalem after they had finished with Israel. The Assyrian king Sennacherib's army marched towards Jerusalem. As they approached the city, warning horn sounded. Farmers left their fields and ran to the city. The great bronze gates were slammed. They were shut violently. Hezekiah and his generals waited nervously. When the Assyrians came within striking range of the city walls, they pitched camp and prepared for battle. The people of Jerusalem were filled with terror. Then came a surprise. Isaiah sent this message to Hezekiah. "This is what the Lord has said about the Assyrian emperor. He will not enter the city or shoot a single arrow against it. I will defend this city and protect it for the sake of my own honor and because of the promise I made to my servant David." Night fell. The people of Jerusalem stayed awake due to fear. When the sun rose, people could scarcely believe what they saw. The Assyrians were breaking their camp and leaving. When the Assyrian armies had gone, the Hebrew patrols went out to the campsite and found it littered with dead. What happened? There was a sudden outbreak of the bubonic plague that triggered the disaster. It was truly an angel from heaven in Judah's eyes. Jerusalem breathed a sigh of relief. Children, let's imagine the people of Jerusalem together with King Hezekiah all shaken up because they have been surrounded by the mighty Assyrian army. The Assyrians had already captured Israel. The capture of Jerusalem would mean the end of Judah. In this tensed situation, the Lord's message comes through Isaiah, which we will now listen attentively. Let us take a comfortable posture. Keep your palms open facing upwards on your lap. Quieten your mind by taking a few deep breaths and gently close your eyes and listen to the scriptures. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord concerning the king of Assyria. He shall not come into the city of Jerusalem, shoot an arrow there, come before it with a shield, or cast up a siege ramp against it. By the way that he came, by the same he shall return. He shall not come into this city, says the Lord. For I will defend this city to save it. For my own sake and for the sake of my servant David. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. What would be the feelings in the hearts of the people in Jerusalem? Complete confidence in God? Or maybe a mixed feelings of fear and trust in Yahweh. If you were in the walled city, what kind of a prayer would you have made? You would have cried and said, "Save me, Lord, save me." Talk to God about one tensed and difficult problem you are facing now. The pandemic, COVID-19, for which you require to boost your confidence in God. Pray to God and ask Him to fill you with confidence in Him in your life. Abba, Father, Almighty and Eternal God, provident refuge in every danger, turn your gaze towards us. Comfort to those who weep. Grant good health to the sick. Give me confidence in the power of your grace, that even when I am afraid, I may put my whole trust in you, so that together we might glorify your holy name. Amen. Now gently open your eyes and let us sing the well-known hymn, which is based on the book of Isaiah. Sign ourselves in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So children, it's time for your activity. You are going to write few lines on how you think your confidence in God has grown during this pandemic. And you are going to send it to your Sunday school teacher. Your teacher is waiting for your activities. It is improper to rely on any other power except the power of God. A Lord will never forget his people. He will always protect all of us under his wings. So children, see you next Sunday. Stay safe. Take care. Bye-bye.